Hey guys, welcome to Medical TubeMed channel. Today's our topic is HPI. HPI means history of present illness. So what is HPI? HPI is a chronological description of present illness from the initial sign to the present. So HPI is a part of history. Say for example, patient suffering from abdominal pain from last 5 days. So patient having abdominal pain from the last 5 days, and now also patient having same problem. So that is only the chronological description of patient present illness. So for in HPI there are elements. So there are total 8 elements. So I am going to explain one by one very quickly. So let's start. So guys, as I told, there are total 8 elements of HPI. So in that H, I'm starting with location. So what is location? Location means body location, organ system affected, where the problem located. For example, right knee, throat. Actually, where the problem is located. For example, any body location, any organ system that affected particular organ, and where the problem is located. So you can see here right knee pain. So right knee is a location. See, so that we can consider as a location while counting in HPI. One more thing, as I told one example, abdominal pain from last 5 days. So in that condition, we can consider abdominal pain means abdomen as a location. So next element is quality. So quality means characteristic and description of sensation or pain. For example, dull, sharp, burning, radiating. Means the patient suffering from any problem, and that it's a description of that pain. So for example, a dull pain, sharp, it's a radiating, burning sensation. So in that case, we can consider this is as a quality. So the next one is severity. So description of severity or radiating on pain scale. Normally, doctor mentioned that mild, moderate, severe means pain. So, for example, I told severe abdominal pain. So, in that condition, we can consider severe as a severity, and abdominal pain means abdomen as a location. So, most of the time, doctor has mentioned mild, moderate, severity, progressive, worse. Is related that words we can consider as a severity, means the problem is increasing. Severity is increasing or decreasing, but doctor has to be mentioned like that. So one more thing, sometime the doctor has mentioned pain scale, pain measurement scale. You can see here. So here 0 to 10, these are the numbers. For example, 6 by 10. So out of 10, patient is suffering for up to 6, means hurting, severe pain. We can consider it for a severe pain. In that peak, you can see 0 means no pain. Okay, after that, mild pain, moderate pain, severe pain, very severe pain, and 10 means worst pain, like that. So these are the severity. So guys, next, timing. When or frequency? So when a problem happen, what is the frequency of that problem? For example, persistent, intermittent, in the morning. So for example, means it's basically a timing of problem. See, persistence means it's a continue to exist or occur over the prolonged time. Intermittent pain, like that sometime they will mention. Intermittent means occurring at irregular interval, not continuous or not a steady. So such a type of means it's a timing. For example, abdominal pain started in the morning and it's intermittent. So in that sentence, we can consider intermittent. They use intermittent pain and started in the morning, means intermittent and morning, both are the timing we can consider. And abdominal pain means it's a location. So that time we can consider one point in that is location, one point, and timing is another one point. So guys, our next point is duration. So length of duration of symptom, for example, 3 days ago. So next, since last Monday, approximately 2 months ago. So for example, leg pain and leg cramping from last 2 months, and today it's increasing. So in that scenario, we can consider approximately, they have mentioned approximately 2 months ago means it's a duration time. Time span, if they mention time span means we can consider it's a duration. So like that. The next is context. So what is the context? Circumstances around a description of how symptom and problem happen. It's very simple. See, so patient having any problem. So how that problem has been happened, that is only the context. So for example, while playing basketball, patient injured. So while playing basketball, so playing basketball is a context. Okay. While working, fall, accident also context, fall from ladder during painting. While painting, the painter fall down, that is the context, and next element is associated sign and symptom. So when we have to count associated sign and symptom in HPI count, that is additional symptom offered by the patient. And what other factor does patient experiencing in addition to this discomfort, pain, for example, SOB, nausea, vomiting. So these are the sign and symptom associated with the present problem. See, for example, patient came for gastritis, patient having abdominal pain, gastritis, GERD, anything with that particular CHIP complaint. For example, patient having GERD and patient also having nausea and vomiting is the associated sign and symptom. So that time we have to consider associated sign and symptom as a HPI count. Our next and last element is modifying factor. What is modifying factor? What makes problem better or worse? For example, OTC pain reliever, rest, exertion, factor that aggravated problem. So that we can consider as a modifying factor. So for example, while taking, after taking OTC pain reliever, patient feeling relief. Then rest, after taking rest, patient feeling relief. Then exertion, in the example of exertion, because of exertion pain getting worse. So these are the modifying factor. You can see on that peak, patient applying hot water bag on neck. So because of applying hot water bag on neck, patient feeling relief from that neck pain. So in that condition, we can consider as a modifying factor. So that is only our today's point, elements of HPI.